Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to solve some examples related to the conversion of the different systems of bearing. So let's solve example number one, in which the bearing of AB line is given in quadrantal bearing system and we are being asked to convert it into whole circle bearing system. So let's draw the sketch first. We know the standard direction. Since it is being given to us that the line is in southeast quadrant and the bearing is 24 degree 11 minutes. So the line is to be drawn in southeast quadrant and this angle is being taken from south. So the line may be somewhere over here. So this angle is given to us, which is 24 degree 11 minutes. Since it is being asked to convert into the whole circle bearing system, so we know that in whole circle bearing, the angle is always being measured from north and clockwise. So then this will be the angle. So this angle is required. We know that the total angle from north to south is 180 degree. So subtracting 24 degree 11 minutes from 180 degree will give us then the required angle. So after doing some simple calculations, we will have the final value as 155 degree 49 minutes. So this is the bearing of the line AB in whole circle bearing system. Now let's move on to example number 2. In this example, we are being given with the CD line and the bearing of that line is given in whole circle bearing system. We are being asked to convert it into the quadrantal bearing system. So let's draw again the sketch first. So we know that in whole circle bearing system, the angle is being measured from north and clockwise. So 214 degree 25 minutes would be lying over here. So this is CD line and the angle from north to the line is 214 degree 25 minutes. And we know that in quadrantal bearing system, the angle is to be measured from north or south, whichever is near. Here the south is nearer, so this angle would be measured from south. So this angle is required. So again, we know that from north to south, the angle is 180. So if we subtract 180 from 214 degree 25 minutes, then we will have the remaining angle. So after doing the calculation, we will get the angle as 34 degree 25 minutes. Since in quadrantal bearing system, we have to write the quadrant in which the line lies. So southwest is the quadrant. So then this is the final answer. Example number 3. In this example, we have been given with a PQ line and its bearing is given in quadrantal bearing system. We are being asked to convert it into the whole circle bearing system. So again, draw the sketch first and the line is in southwest quadrant. So the line is to be drawn first and the bearing is 24 degree 45 minutes in southwest quadrant, and in order to convert into the whole circle bearing system, the angle should be measured from north clockwise. So this is the angle that is required to us. So this angle can be calculated if we add 180 with the 24 degree 45 minutes, then we will get the answer. So if we do the calculation, the answer will come out to be 204 degree 25 minutes. In the last example, example number 4, in which the bearing of CD line is given and it is given in a whole circle bearing system, we have to convert it into the quadrantal bearing system. So draw the sketch. So 311 degree 35 minutes would be over here. The line is CD. So angle from north to the line measured clockwise is 311 degree 35 minutes. Since we are being asked to convert it into the quadrantal bearing system, so the angle can be measured from north or south. In this case, the line is near to north, so the angle would be measured from north. So then this will be the angle. So in order to calculate this angle, we know that in a complete circle the total angle is 360. So if we subtract 311 degree 35 minutes from 360, we will have then this remaining angle. So by doing the calculation, we will get 49 degree 15 minutes. Since the system is a quadrantal bearing system, quadrant is also to be written along with the angle. So northwest is the quadrant. So NW is to be written. This is the answer. So this is all from this video, in which we have solved 4 examples related to the conversion of the different systems of bearing. That's it. Thank you very much.